Hi, I'm Mike Stanton with Build America Mutual. Today is October 22nd. This is the BAM Weekly Muni Market Update. I'm here with Brian Babler and Dan Bingham from BAM's Capital Markets Desk. Thank you for being here, gentlemen. You are busy. As we talked about last week, a heavy calendar this week. BAM posted its busiest week ever with more than $1 billion of new issues priced. Brian, let's start with you. Talk about some of the highlights.
Yeah, it was a busy week. And in the market in general, supply ticked up to around $12.5 billion, along the lines of the similar type of split we've been seeing, about 27% or almost $3.5 billion in the taxable space and about $9.1 billion for exempts. And, I'll start with some just kind of brief market commentary. Over the last couple of weeks, we've definitely felt some of the tax-exempt market feel a little bit sluggish. If you think about it in the context of the rate moves that we've seen in treasuries for the month of October, on October 1st, 10-year treasury was a 146, and as of yesterday had backed up to a 170. Treasuries are rallying a little bit this morning, but a pretty decent backup on the 30-year. October 1st number was a 202, and as of yesterday's close was around a 215. So decent moves on the Treasury side. Before yesterday's cuts to the MMD scale, which was about 5 basis points, 10-year MMD had only ticked up from a 114 on October 1st to a 119 before yesterday's cut, and 30-year really hardly moved from a 167 to a 168 before yesterday. So really, outperformance on the tax exempt side, that's pushed ratios a little bit. And, it's really made the tax exempt market just get a little bit harder. Deals are still getting done, but it's taken some minor adjustments. And again, yesterday was really the first day that we saw any substantial cuts to the MMD scale. On the heels of Lipper fund flows abating a little bit. This week we're reported around 177 million. That's quite a bit down from the billion or billion and a half that we've been averaging. It's gotten a little bit more challenging, but all that said, 12.5 billion got priced, and insurance definitely played a very substantial part in that this week. We don't have the exact final tallies, but we're estimating around 1.5 to 2 billion is likely to end up with insurance on that new issue side. So around 12 to almost 15% penetration, which, it's really nice to see insurance helping deals get done, minimizing spread widening, and helping with the liquidity of transactions. As you mentioned, BAM had our busiest week. We priced over 1.1 billion in par. That was across 40 different series in 13 different states. Our mix between tax exempts and taxables was pretty much in line with the market, about 77% of the deals in the tax exempt space. And as we've been talking about for several weeks, we continue to see activity in higher rated underlying credits. Some of the highlights from this week.
Before you jump into the details of the transactions, Dan, just wanted to get you into the conversation a little bit. We've been talking leading up to this week, literally for over a month now, about how the seasonal trends typically favor this kind of performance in the marketplace. But obviously, there's also the overlay of inflation uncertainty. What are you hearing in terms of, what are the key drivers of investor behavior there?
I think you touch on the, one of the biggest predictable patterns of the municipal market or the seasonal patterns, where you get cash flows into the market pretty dramatically in January, July, that cash sort of ebbs in the April, October period, and we're right in the middle of the October seasonal weakness. So you see that in the cash flows, as Brian touched on, cash flows have dried up to a large extent from the billion plus inflows weekly to this week's 100 million. And I wouldn't be surprised to see that number go negative in the next week or two. But you also see it in some of the performances Brian touched on. Munis have been performing pretty well up until yesterday, where you saw a decent rate backup and Muni investors finally got concerned about some of that movement. And you saw a 5 basis point adjustment on the MMD. And with that, the long ratio is currently at 82%. So we're in the throes of that seasonal period that you, the seasonal weak period that you touch on. But, you know, it's important to note also that that quickly reverses. November is sort of a slow period, but December and January are a very strong period. So the market will start to price in, or should start to price in, that better seasonal period in the next couple of weeks or so.
Great. So Brian, back to you. So what transactions stood out to you from BAM's calendar this week?
Yeah, so some of the highlights certainly include, we wrapped about $270 million out of a total of $300 million for Oakland USD in California. That was priced by Siebert. Jeffries had a very active week utilizing insurance. We insured about $191 million for a UC-Irvine student housing transaction. Jeffries also used us on a $174 million Wildwood Utility District in Florida. Some of the other larger deals included Oxnard USD in California, which was a taxable deal priced by Raymond James. And then we were used in the competitive space on about $92 million out of $200 million total on Clark County School District in Nevada. And that deal was purchased by Morgan Stanley. So fairly diverse set of activity, as I mentioned earlier, covered 13 different states, which is a pretty good number for weekly activity.
And those partial transactions always stand out as efforts where the underwriters are really, where you don't have massive oversubscription across the curve, the underwriters are looking to make sure they're matching demand, you know, whether it's tax insurable or uninsured, directly to the supply. So it's that's where the partials can be really helpful to issuers in getting their transactions placed. So any other observations? So next week, most a quieter month, quieter week overall for the calendar, as well as for BAM. Any hints on what you're looking forward to in November?
Yeah, next week will slow down a little bit. I think the headline number for supply is probably right around 8 billion, maybe just a little bit under that. That should start to pick up. I think that'll be a little bit of an anomaly, again, depending on where rates go from here. But over the last several weeks and months, the market really has been anticipating a pretty robust end of the year. So we're expecting November, December to continue to be a fairly heavy supply. Again, we're the market is continuing to watch any news or momentum out of Washington as it relates to any of the items you know, that could potentially impact what decisions issuers make, whether they wait for advance refundings to come back, whether they proceed with taxable refundings. All of that depends on where the Treasury market goes. Again, today we're rallying back a little bit here on the Treasury side, so any improvement there could help pull some refunding deals back into the money. So, you know, next week will be a little bit quiet to end the month of October, but November, December, or at least the first half of December should continue to be, you know, fairly active on the new issue side.
Yeah, it certainly seems like the conventional wisdom among issuers and their advisors is if the transaction's in the money as a taxable refunding, go ahead and lock that in. Because even if advance refundings, tax exempt advance refundings come back, you don't know what the interest rate environment's going to look like. So that seems to be a tailwind for volume. Well, thanks, guys. Congratulations on a great week, and we'll talk to you soon.
Great. Thanks, Mike.
Thanks, Mike.
Investing in America's infrastructure drives our country forward. Municipal bonds help strengthen America's backbone and connect us all through essential investment in local opportunities. At Build America Mutual, we maximize the safety and stability of municipal bond investments. That means a bright future for our communities and investors' portfolios. Learn more about the exceptional security of BAM-insured bonds.